run 2 or 3 ads a year in the American Heart Review. And other than that, we just have those web pages out there on the internet.
There was more interest this year, I think, than there's been there ever has been. We had so many inquiries and people coming in. And we actually have a waiting list. So that's the first thing.
10 times what you transfer.
Then you could pick and choose.
Yeah.
You know, no.
So yeah, we're hopeful about the future.
Or it'll happen. Maybe the next century.
Oh, Richard, always the optimist.
Now, if you would have said that last year, it wouldn't have been such a long time.
Yeah.
Richard, be careful. There's a bee in your
mouth. I know. I was trying. Oh. I wanted to drop in there.
We'll get together. No, I was about to say this.
Aren't you going to tell them the best?
Thank you. Every time you report, it's like, it reminds me of that saying of science.
That I think you'd find kind of interesting.
I'm working on it.
That's interesting. You were a very dashing young man, Richard.
Oh, you're dashing now.
He's a very dashing now.
Oh, sorry.
All right. What I did is we had artists that came to the reunion 2 years ago, and artists from out of town sent in letters, got these photos. He was a student, so it's all alphabetical, and letters from...
That's important.
Reproduction of the paintings.
This is your legacy.
So just a little...
You ask people to
send in letters.
Or send in letters.
Yeah. And this is what I did with it.
We're so old, we forgot all about it. Hi, Barb.
How'd you get in here?
I don't want to stand here.
Well, I got it in the mail from my son yesterday. Well, yeah, that's why we set this up for this weekend.
Oh,
did he cut it close?
Yeah, he cut it close. It made me very nervous.
Oh, that's amazing. I had no idea. Yeah.
Oh, there's so many fun stories in there.
Some, you know, that are fairly recent works that they sent me, so you shouldn't be able to enjoy it.
How many did you make?
No,
just
no.
One. But you could make more. It's been
interesting. I feel a headache.
Pretty labor intensive.
It's very labor intensive. Of course, now that we have it on disc.
I suppose he could do it in a different format. It wouldn't have to be...
It could be maybe done in a not mounted quite the way.
Not mounted, yeah. Sent this.
This is fabulous. Janet, this to me is such a candy.
Well, I wanted to just kind of surprise you.
You kind of set it up, though, by showing
the book
that,
made for me
that Joel made for Gary.
Really beautiful.
Yeah,
well, I thought you'd be great to be a teacher.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's true. If you don't go into it, you end up that way.
God, you got everybody in Mike Challenge.
Well, and I even snuck myself in there. I hope you don't mind that I took that liberty. Actually, I'd like to read you, I think, what I wrote.
Oh. Get out the hanky.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh,
there
you
go.
And there
it is.
Yeah, let me read this to you if you don't mind. I'd like to just take the opportunity
to
express my feelings of, I need my glasses. They're right inside the door there. I'm wondering how I'm going to react to this. Here's a big picture of me.
So you can't miss it.
Yeah. I'll never forget the first time I met you. I had been preparing for this meeting for almost 2 years, developing a business plan to create an organization that would promote the artists of your tradition in their work. Little did I know what it would become or how this meeting would change my life. Little did you know how nervous I was. It was December 15th, 1987 at 7 in the evening. I knocked on the back door and was greeted by a lovely woman with a Hungarian accent, Catherine. Upon entering, I could see through the entry, past hand-decorated swinging doors into the main room. At first, I was intrigued, for I saw a large, fully decorated Christmas tree standing on top of a beautiful grand piano. Upon entering, I was dazzled. Everywhere I looked, I saw paintings reaching to the ceiling. I was speechless and didn't know what to say. Any compliment I could think of seemed banal or trite. Rather than betraying myself, I focused on the task at hand, our meeting. To this day, I often find it difficult. To express my feelings for your work. Did someone else read this?
I'll try. I bet I'll probably cry too. Okay, where did we get? Every painting I've seen touches a different room in my soul. They speak to me in a very personal way that transcends words. Looking at your landscapes, I find myself transported to that place and that time with that light. Your florals capture the dazzling display of nature at its best. Your portraits transcend an accurate portrayal of a person's likeness. They capture the essence of that person's life. Your imaginative work speaks to me in a language I'm still learning to understand. Yet in their mystery, I see a visual harmony that draws me to them. I sense their meaning before I understand what I actually see at an intellectual level. We have shared a fascinating journey. Over the past 12 years, I've come to know you as a mentor and a friend. You have filled my world with beauty, knowledge, insight, and more. You offered guidance to a young man who once dreamed of being a painter, but realized he had a different role to play. You filled a void in my life by presenting to me a tangible connection to the old masters, and you taught me how to see a painting through your eyes, a gift that I can never repay. At the same time, we shared the struggles, joys, and frustrations of living day to day. In many ways, you've been like a father to me, and I treasure our weekly lunch visits. How could I ever know that I would one day meet the man that I longed to find when I was a boy? The one person who knew how to paint as the old masters. And that one day I would call him my friend. Thank you, Richard, for making a young boy's dream come true.
Very nice.
There's some wonderful letters in there, and every person said something from the heart as well as something anecdotal. and there's some funny stories in there, and there's some stories about what was going on behind your back.
Oh, yes.
That's very important to have that.
Yeah.
What was going on behind my back?
I am sure. Oh,
some little shenanigans that they might be surprised to find out what you did know. And maybe never said anything about.
Well, I think we all owe a debt of gratitude to Gary, too, for everything he's done.
Oh, yes.
Over the years, for the society and everything else.
Thank you. Yeah. Absolutely. You know, I was thinking we and our bunch of get-togethers, we've covered just about everything.
Hey, Gary, now we don't have to publish the other book.
There you go.
Well, see,
you
Gary,
got
we
it,
all
right?
want to put it in order.
So, Gary, did your son design it?
He and I worked on it, designed it together.
It's a beautiful
yeah.
That's a huge
he came up with the general format, and then I went in and just did some tweaking and adjusting and put my own eye to it. But basically, it's really his conceptual look.
Beautiful, the way it's
done. Yeah.
I'm going to save it for a nice.
Yes,
and I can think anything.
Mm-hmm. Well, I thank you. I say I'm speechless.
I know.
We thank you.
I didn't have any idea what it was about, but you know, this is.
No, I wanted to kind of surprise you
with everything. It's a wonderful way, you know. Someone like myself, I put a lot of work and effort into teaching different people. A thing like this really puts it down in history.
Well, and it helps to have you have something tangible you can hold and you can take a look at the work of your students and what they're going on and the legacy that's living on from all that you have given them, but also what they want to share back with you and the letters that they've written to you.
You know, my kids haven't any idea what I've been doing, so this will be wonderful for them to look at this. And I tell them all I teach. Kids never take you seriously, but this is something they're going to really be astonished by. Lordy. This is so wonderful.
Well, shall we bring the Kleenex?
I wonder if I'll dry now.
Well, I was thinking now he will start having the tears.
Well, when I read it.
I was up on the North Shore, yeah, before your show, out at the Newington Cropsey. And it comes full circle at the end. There's photographs from the reunion.
I don't know.
Well, this is the nicest thing you could have given me. I know such painters, many painters have been privileged to have their students. Work hard to achieve such good results.
Oh, we did.
Something
I was
like in
the full length of work.
In today's world, which is so difficult to do serious things in the arts or anything for that matter.
And that was at your reunion picnic in your backyard.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That'd be good.
I turned it off.
Yeah.
You needed to go down to
it. Absolutely. Yeah. I always love that.
We have another book that
thank you
put together for his retirement. But it's not it's from.
Yeah, okay.
A newspaper article for us.
Yeah, it'll take a while to read them all. There's a lot of letters.
Did you know?
Well, he's been driving for 2 years and calling on us and getting them.
Oh, you know, the original letter was sent to a family tree. It said that.
It, you know, it was sent, and I wonder if
all that information.
Yeah, yeah, sure. And I wonder if he went through and looked at everybody's well.
Yeah, it's a,
they did a quite a
legacy
together and binding it.
Or people have branched out enough that they're.
A wonderful group of artists who are going to continue on carrying the mantle.
Yeah. I would guess that you'd forget them. Meaningful it is.
This is extra special. I don't know what it is, but then
when did you get the idea?
Yeah.
None of that work.
You know, something that tangible that came out of a while ago.
I like
that.
All my dreams. I like that. I never really
everybody see
did get up and go.
Yeah.
Well, everybody's going to see that. That's amazing.
You knew about this, of course.
No.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I didn't. I didn't know anything about it. I knew as much as you did, which was nothing.
Well, that's a reward beyond measure.
Well, you deserve it. Few people, are fortunate enough to have a real tangible proof of what they've done in their life.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah.
That is a huge gift. It's a.
And that's not his.
No, that's what I mean. It's like you plant a few seeds and then here is the result.
Yeah, it's gonna
I mean,
go
that represents so many lives.
That is
it. And that's only part of it.
That's why I said, did you make that for yourself? No, I mean, you could tell what you
it's all indirect. It's all disgorged.
But this is, all this art is done.
And it's well, by burning lots of burgers, it's got to be a different way. You know, the interesting thing about this, I think of it often, that in today's world, people have to have grants, and they've got to have all kinds of things to support it.
I think when they're juicing out,
we just went our way, right?
Okay.
We just, day to day, went at the training a little bit and didn't worry about it. Occasionally, at least I worried about some things, but the, it shows what one can do. You just put your, set your sights and just work at it, and you get a few people together that are interested in the same thing.
Well, that's the thing today.
Yeah, that's very moving.
No, no, no.
And the one thing in art, it's for the ages. So there's so much in our society which is superficial and it's overnight success. I think what we've done is going to just go on into the future, gain in stature.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that is amazing.
I mean, that's some wonderful work, too. Yeah.
Amazing.
Dinner is served.
Uh-oh.
And you're welcome to either eat inside.